In this video, we're given the dimensions of a rectangular property in feet, and that includes uncertainties on those measurements. So each of those is measured to within 1/2 of a foot uncertainty. And we're planning to use propagation of error in part A to compute the area of this property in square feet and then attach the correct uncertainty to it. Then in part B, we do a unit conversion between square feet and acres, and we consider our conversion factors to be exact so they don't influence the precision of the answer that we got in part A. So to start things out, I'm going to get the area of this rectangular property. And all I have to do is multiply the two dimensions, length and width. It doesn't matter what order I do those in. So I have 151 feet times 202.5 feet. And when I run the numbers on this, I get to many significant digits. For now, 30,578 square feet. Now we need to work on the uncertainty in this measurement. How do we incorporate the uncertainties in the individual dimensions to get the uncertainty in the area? And for this, we use the propagation of errors formula for a product of two quantities. So I have the relative uncertainty in A, that's delta A over A. The uncertainty divided by the size of A itself is given by the square root of the relative uncertainty in length squared, that's delta L over L squared, in a similar term for W, the width. So we plug the numbers in there, and when I plug into my calculator, I end up with 0.00413, just keeping a few significant digits there. Now this is the relative uncertainty in A. In other words, this tells us what the percent uncertainty is in the area, and it's about 0.4% if I were to convert that to a percent. And what we need out of this is the actual uncertainty in area instead of the relative uncertainty. So I have to take this 0.00413 and I multiply by A in order to isolate delta A, the uncertainty in the area. So delta A is going to be A, and I already computed that, 30,578 square feet times this 0.00413. And this gives me 126.3 square feet of uncertainty. Now we're asked in this problem to follow a convention of rounding the uncertainty to one significant digit. So this is how I handle it in my physics labs. So I'm going to say this is approximately 100. I'm rounding down here, 100 square feet, one significant digit on the uncertainty itself. Then we round the original quantity to the same decimal place, in other words, the hundreds place. And this is where I get my final answer. So A is going to be rounded to 30,600 square feet. So the total area here is 30,600 plus or minus my uncertainty in area, which was 100 square feet. So just as a reminder, this propagation of errors approach is the truly correct way of looking at how uncertainty propagates in a calculation. Keeping track of significant digits is a heuristic method that's kind of an approximation to how you're supposed to do it, but propagation of errors is the most correct way. And if I look at what would happen in this calculation, if I were to use significant digits instead of propagation of error, my length and width both had 4 significant digits, and I would have rounded my answer to 4 significant digits. Well, it turns out that our error is so big, it only makes sense to keep 3 significant digits in the final calculation when we do this in the most correct way. In part B, we're doing a unit conversion now on this area of 30,600 square feet. And I'm asked to just keep the same number of significant digits as I got in the answer to part A. So I'm going to start with that number, 30,600. And then I need to get to acres. And the conversion that I have here is the number of acres in a square mile. And then I have the number of feet in a mile. So the first thing we're going to do is convert these square feet to square miles. And that requires 2 applications of this conversion factor. So I have 5,280 feet in a mile, and I need to square that conversion factor so it cancels 2 factors of feet, leaving me with square miles. Then I tack on my conversion factor of 1 square mile in the denominator for every 640 acres in the numerator. And this gives me an answer of 0.702 acres, again, keeping 3 sig figs. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.